Welcome one, welcome all to Van Nord Arena, home of the Calvin Knights in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Tonight we have some men's basketball action between the Adrian Bulldogs and your Calvin Knights. My name's Ryan Schumer. I'm a freshman here on the baseball team, joined by my partner in crime, Ryan Sherrard. How are we doing on this beautiful Saturday afternoon here in Grand Rapids, Ryan?
You know, doing fantastic. It's a great afternoon for some Calvin Knights basketball. Got a win earlier in the women's game. Got to call that one, so that was a fun time. The Knights had no problem taking care of the Bulldogs earlier this afternoon, so we'll see if that can be the same here tonight.
Yeah, the Knights on the women's side getting ahead of things early, able to put things away and really leading the game for most of the second half by 20-plus, and really just doing a good job through the full court press and everything. Let's see if the Knights can do that themselves. We've seen them do really well through the starts of games and not so great right after halftime, so really looking forward to the lull after halftime to continue scoring, especially from the man underneath, Jalen Overway, averaging 20.7 points per game, along with Uchenna Ekekeza, averaging 11, the man of the hour for the Bulldogs, Nick Seifert, averaging 11 a game, along with Kendall Crispin, also averaging 10.88, so some big-time names to watch out for.
Yeah, and we'll see how the Bulldogs go about defending the Jalen Overway, the returning All-American, averaging just under 21 points per game this season, and we've seen him have some really big games as of late.
Yeah, the Knights coming off two losses against Hope and Trine, able to pick up the win 4 days ago at Alma on the 31st, a 15-point margin. Let's see if they can continue to get the wheels going again.
Yeah, definitely. And this Knights team, they're streaky. You know, they'll have their hot spells, but they'll also have their cold spells. So it's just a matter of getting those cold spells to be just a little bit less on the downward. You know, as we saw, back-to-back losses, losing to Hope, losing to Trine right there. Not an ideal way, but we'll see if the Knights can just continue to bounce back like they did against Alma at home.
Yeah, something really big for the Knights to watch out as they continue later in the game is their foul trouble, especially depending on how the officials end up calling this game. And we talked to Coach Saul a few times after some games, and he said his team really just needs to learn how to adjust to calls on the court and adjust their physicality being played in the paint. And along with that, Ryan, we've seen a lot of players foul out, especially in some big time moments in the Hope and Trine game, so something to figure out. And I know, I believe Owen Varnado was out for a few games earlier in the last week, but looks like he's suited up here tonight and looks to be on the court, so it looks like he'll be playing here tonight.
Yeah, Varnado suffering that injury at the end of the Trine game, having to sit out against Hope. A big factor, I think, in that loss is losing Varnado. Varnado not only third on the team in scoring with 9.9 points per game, so basically 10 a game, but also does all of the little things for this team. He's a huge factor rebounding-wise, a huge factor defensively, and is kind of a steady Eddie for this team. Night in and night out, you know you can get his 10 points, but every night he's going to play good defense, he's going to rebound, and he's going to do all the little things and bring the grit to this team.
Yeah, he had a really big game against Trine, like you mentioned. I believe 24 points, so a career high for him. Let's see if him and Jalen Overway can get going underneath. And Jalen Overway, big threat if he can get that three-point shooting going as well, as he dropped 42 at home versus Alma, wins 4-for-4 from behind the arc, and just a dangerous specimen out there if he's hitting from behind the arc.
Absolutely, and with Overway, he's got so many different angles he can come at you from. You know, you got a scheme. Are we going to double team on the block? Is it going to be from the catch? Is it going to be on the help side? So many different schemes we've seen. None of them really work, but so many different schemes, Ryan, we see throwing him. But then when he stretches his game out behind the three-point arc and stretches and draws that those bigs, not only does it make him unguardable, but it opens up backdoor cuts from the corner. So many different other options. He's just such a deadly weapon. And we're so happy that he's in the maroon and gold.
Oh, for sure, Ryan. And I would say it's almost a guarantee that the Bulldogs bring in at least a double team on Jalen Oakway, always off opening up opportunities on the perimeter. And let's hope the Knights can get that three-point shooting going early and allowing Chan Ekekes to go apart on the rim like we always see him do, very physical. Right now, both teams lining up for the national anthem and roster introduction, so we'll turn you over to the PA announcer real quick.
To honor America and those who protect our freedom at home and abroad, please sing along with the playing of our national anthem, which will be performed today by the Calvin Pep Band under the direction of the TCD.
Steiner, Kendall Chrisman, and Josh Jordan. Looks like Bulldogs sending out Jordan for the tip, and the Knights, as always, Overway headed out. Both teams lining up. Bulldogs 4-5 in the MIAA, the Knights 7-2, so a big matchup coming up here this afternoon. And Overway not able to get the jump off tip, so the Bulldogs win the tip. Seifert. Hand off to Chrisman. Rex Steiner with it at the top of the key. Pick and roll shot from Chrisman. No good for the Bulldogs. Bolt with it now. Slowing things down. Ball over to Uchenna Ekekeza. Bernardo in the paint. Back over to Wrestler. Wrestler from behind the arc. No good. Rebound from Dickerson. Passes over to Seifert. Seifert driving on Ekekeza.
Good defense there from Ekekeza. So strong and physical there and able to defend well. The former MIAA Defensive Player of the Year.
Yeah, big defense from Uchenna Ekekeza. Dickerson passing to Jordan. No good. Varnado and Overway with the tip. Wrestler brings it down. Varnado passing over to Ekekeza. Ekekeza on the rim. Rims out. No good. Bulldogs, Dickerson bringing it up the floor. No points so far. Jordan handoff to Seifert from behind the arc, and he makes that one.
Yeah, good shot there from Seifert, rising up with the defender in his face and able to finish that one from behind the arc. Good shooting start for him.
Bolt now with it on the far side, looking for options. Arnato now driving back to Ekekeza. Bulldogs in a man-to-man. Varnado kicking out to Bolt on in the corner. Three, no good. Now the Bulldogs. Chrisman hands off to Seifert. Posting up is Jordan. No good off the rim. Wrestler snags the rebound. Wrestler up the floor. Kicks to Bolt. Bolt to Ekekeza. Wrestler in the corner, Overweight posting up underneath. And Ryan, something the Knights have got to do is get that ball into Jalen Overway as it gets it around the perimeter behind the arc. Ekekeza driving, steps out of bounds. Bulldogs ball.
And we can kind of see, too, as Overway staying behind the arc a little bit more than usual, pulling the Bulldogs defense, opening up the driving lanes for others here.
Yeah, Ekekeza will definitely take advantage of those, and we've seen him a bunch. Something else to see, Ryan, is Ekekeza jumping those lobbed passes. We've seen him get a lot of steals on those and some fast break opportunities. Seifert into Jordan. Jordan posting up. Varnado gets a hand on it.
Good job by Varnado there, getting on the floor, putting in some effort early on. We talked about him a little bit in the pregame and his effort and what he brings to this team, not only with the scoring.
Overway snags the rebound, trying to hit Varnado. Number 24, Chrisman, able to get a hand on it. Bolt inbounding on the near side. Wrestler getting some contact from number 20, Rex Steiner. Overway underneath, looking to go up, and a foul call drawn by Overway.
Yeah, and we'll see how the Knights go about getting Overway the basketball down low. He's so efficient. We talk so much about him and his scoring abilities, but his efficiency is something that really separates him from other outstanding players.
Knights able to get the inbound. Bernardo with it, 15 to shoot. Ekekeza in the corner. Bernardo posting up underneath. Goes to the rim and in.
Varnado
driving his way in, using his physicality well.
Yeah, really nice move and finish there from Owen Varnado. Getting inside, strong finish. Two points.
Fake there from Chrisman. Gets Bolt in the air. 2 points for Chrisman. Wrestler driving, takes it himself. Batted out. Another inbound opportunity for the Knights. Jordan Scott checking in.
And, you know, freshman Jordan Scott checking in, and he's played very well for this team. You know, we kind of gotten to see him progress as he's gotten more comfortable and has been a really good impact player for this Knights team, kind of stepping into more of a sixth man kind of role. And anytime he's out there, he's really able to settle in and control the basketball. Very talented and gifted with the ball handling as well as shooting and creating shots and setting up his teammates.
Varnado takes a shot from three, no good. Overway, offensive rebound and off the glass and in. Great offensive rebound there from Overway. And you know, as you were saying, from Jordan Scott, freshman, really impact freshman, got a lot of confidence out there, really good. Backdoor cut from the Bulldogs, number three, Michael Reitnoir.
And that nice no-look pass right there reminded me of Jordan Scott. When Jordan Scott's out there, you gotta beware for some fancy passes. His court vision is kind of what separates him from a lot of other guys and a lot of other point guards, is his ability to see everything on the floor and throw some fancy no-look passes every now and then to get the crowd off on their feet.
For sure, Ryan, and Overway double teamed underneath and Bolt from three.
Yeah, it's good to see Marcus Bolt find the bottom of the net right there. Been in a little bit of a shooting slump, but when he gets hot, he can shoot it like the best of them. And so good to see him getting one fall early. This team needs him in his contributions.
And an attempt from behind the line for the Bulldogs. No good. Echenna Ekekeza driving underneath. Barnato gets the offensive rebound after block shot. Echenna Ekekeza from three. No good. Too short. Bulldogs driving in transition. Seifert kicks out and a shot from the corner, no good.
Good rebound there by Jordan Scott to box out a significantly larger defender.
Fancy ball work, Overway from three, no good, off the rim.
That's what we talked about too, Overway stepping into that shot with some confidence, getting more confident with his feel from that shot behind the arc. Honestly, turning into one of the better three-point threats from this night's team.
Yeah, really interesting that you bring that up, Ryan. And Barnato gets it stripped, be off the Bulldogs. We saw some attempted fancy shot there on the other end by Josh Jordan, trying to go behind the back on Jalen Overway as we see Owen Barnato coming out and trip Reimersma in for the Knights.
We can applaud this defensive tenacity and effort from the Bulldogs, really giving good ball pressure and making the Knights uncomfortable here early on.
Yeah, definitely more of a physical game than we've seen so far, and really good to see physical basketball as Reimersma into the rim and off the glass. Knights have their first lead of the game.
Nice little basket cut there by Reimersma and able to find him for the finish.
Morrow thinking about it. Number 14, Schilling, takes a three-point try. No good. Three Knights grabbing for the ball, still end up with it. Ekekeza finds.
And a good find there, too. Jordan Scott from the corner able to find a cutting Marcus Bolt, and he's going to go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Number one, yeah, good find there from Jordan. Really great in transition. Ekekeza to Scott, and Scott finding a cutting Marcus Bolt. Bolt looking to add on to his already 3 points early on in the first. The first from Bolt is good.
Yeah, Bolt hits that first one, shooting 63% from the free throw line here, so a solid free throw shooter for this Knights team.
Bolt looking for his second, and the Knights leading by three currently. No good, rim out for Marcus Bolt on his second free throw try. DJ Morrow hands off to Seifert. And Ryan, something I've really loved about the Bulldogs through their offensive progression so far is they're moving the ball around the perimeter extremely fast, not allowing the Knights to really get settled at all on the defensive end. The Knights doing some of their own. Ekekeza with it, gets it into Overway. Overway taking himself and an and one.
A really nice job there by the Knights, setting up Jalen Overway to get the basketball and catch it so where he can just pound strong, turn through contact, absorb the hit, and he's as talented as they come with the finish.
And there you have it, folks. 30-second timeout from the Bulldogs as the Knights take a 5-point lead. And that's really interesting, Ryan. The Knights kind of starting off slow there for a second, then Marcus Bolt hits a 3-point try, and Jalen Overway doing his thing underneath, allows for the Knights to get that lead, and next thing you know, it's five. Next thing you know, it's 10, 15, 20. And so the Bulldogs really trying to slow things down right now before this Jalen Overway free throw. Coming into the game right now, it looks like Brady Ewing is still out on the side, so that'll be for Jalen Overway. If he makes this free throw, Brady Ewing will be coming in, a freshman out of Petoskey, Michigan. Overway been a solid free throw shooter from the line. Not able to hit this one. Morrow up the floor for the Bulldogs. Handoff to Rex Steiner. Rex Steiner driving, poked away from Riemersma. Jordan Scott now with it.
Yeah, good job by Riemersma right there to get that hand in and poke that ball away for a steal.
Bolt tries from three, no good. Overway looking for an offensive rebound, gets a hand on it. Seifert pulls it down. Seifert driving. Gets a Bolt jumping and lays it off the glass.
And a really nice hesitation move right there and a fancy finish and pump fake for Seifert.
Scott driving, kicks over to Bolt. Ekekeza at the top of the key. Ekekeza out to Riemersma from three in the corner. Bang! From the corner.
And a good shooting start for these Knights. They've been hot to start from behind the arc.
Yeah, really what you need, especially when the Bulldogs are going to be double-teaming Jalen Overway. Multiple substitutions here for the Knights as we get a travel call. Ewing in along with Ressler, Ambrose, and Winkle. So a four-man swap. Riemersma stays in the game for the Knights. Knights lead by six.
And Winkle, the sharpshooter over there in the corner. So we'll see if he can add to an even hot start for the Knights from around the arc.
Yeah, very much a shooting lineup here for the Knights. Riemersma, Ambrose, and Winkle calling the game as Riemersma pulls up from a jumper. No good off the rim. Seifert driving on Winkle. Lays off the glass, dances on the rim for a second and in.
Yeah, really nice strong take right there, getting in the block, absorbing the hit, and finishing amidst the trees.
Ewing looking for options. Passes in to Winkle. Winkle posting up underneath. Defended by Morrow. And off the glass and out. Dickerson now with it. Passes in to Seifert. Ambrose on him. Seifert driving. It looked to have been an extended elbow there, but call goes foul on Ambrose.
Yeah, it looked like Ambrose moved his feet, but officials say just a little bit late, and that's going to be a blocking foul.
There you have it. Seifert is out. Crispin will be headed in. Varnado back into the game here for the Knights. Trip Riemersma headed back to the bench. Crispin with it, driving on Winkle. Fadeaway jumper off the back of the rim. Ewing pulls down the rebound. Ressler at the top of the key, over to Varnado. Varnado to Ambrose. Ressler thinking about taking a three, drives baseline. Finding Ambrose. Ambrose driving and a travel. Ambrose having an opportunity from behind the arc.
Jalen Overway returns for the Knights.
Jalen Overway in for Brady Ewing. Big man back in the game.
Coach Saul not happy with Matt Ambrose right there for not shooting that first one. Ambrose, a sharp shooting threat for this Knights team. That's one of the big reasons why he's out there is for his three-point shooting ability, and Coach Saul wanted him to shoot that first one. Just shows the confidence Coach Saul has in Ambrose behind the arc.
Yeah, a lot of confidence in Ambrose, and he really deserves it. He's out there making a lot of those three-point tries that he does end up attempting. And a moving screen call there, number 32, Josh Jordan.
Adrian Powell on 32, Jordan.
And that'll be his first on the evening. Winkle on the near side, inbounding to Ressler. Ressler guarded closely by Morrow. Winkle looking in for Overway. Varnado gets it at the top of the key, three-point try, no good.
We've seen Varnado catch the hot hand quite often, so he'll keep shooting, I'm sure, from behind the arc, and when one falls for him, it seems like an abundance of threes just starts raining from heaven.
Yeah, for sure. Hot hand, especially versus Trine, where he had a big career-high 24 points. Driving is Crisman on Winkle. Back off the rim and out. Poked away from Winkle after the defensive rebound.
Number 20, Rex Steiner.
Winkle inbounding once again to Ressler.
Replacing right now.
Ressler passing to Winkle. Winkle looking to find Overway underneath. Ambrose open on the near side. Ambrose from behind the arc, no good. Winkle tips it out. Looks to be an over the back call on Winkle.
Trevin Winkle, that's his first team second.
Ambrose and Wrestler both out. Jordan Scott and Ekekeza back in the ball game. Taking up the court now for the Bulldogs, Nick Seifert, junior out of Tiffin, Ohio. Jordan hands off to Seifert. Seifert trying to dribble his way through the paint.
Good defense there by Bernardo, all over that dribble drive.
Great defense along with Ekekeza. 5 seconds to shoot. Seifert shoots. Bernardo able to come down with the rebound, closely trailing his Recksteiner. Scott driving, hands off to Bernardo. Hits Ekekeza on far side. Overway gets the pass knocked away from him. Dickerson now looking to drive on off the screen of Jordan. Down on the floor, let's see what foul, who's this on? Looks to be on Owen Varnado.
Foul called on Calvin Varnado, it's his first.
Winkle's out, Marcus Bolt back in the game for the Knights. Ryan, it seems like the scoring's kind of dwindled down here in the past few minutes.
Yeah, I think that's due to the credit to defense of both teams. You know, both teams have defended really well here in the past couple of minutes. You know, you saw Owen Vernado picking up that foul there, but he's been playing fantastic defense up until that point of just moving his feet, staying in front, stopping dribble drives, and really just disrupting the rhythm of this Bulldogs defense. And the same down to the other end with the Bulldogs moving their feet and playing good defense and having good ball pressure when the Knights try to get in the rhythm.
And Jordan was able to hit a behind-the-back layup there, coming under the rim. So Bulldogs throw within 2 points. Bernardo with it, hands off to Ekekeza. Ekekeza with some miscommunication with Bernardo. And Ekekeza throws it out of bounds.
Yeah, good defense there from the Bulldogs to disrupt the offensive rhythm of the Knights and forcing a turnover right there and getting the basketball back.
And Scott able to poke it away from the Bulldogs. Ekekeza comes out and Wrestler comes in. Ryan, something that's been a little bit different from games that we've called here for the men's basketball here before is a lot more substitutions that we're used to. A lot more teams coming in, and that'll be
Marcus Bolt picks up his first personal foul.
A foul on Marcus Bolt. Seems to be an off-the-ball call.
You know, finishing that thought you had about the substitutions, I think that's just a testament to this Calvin Knights bench. We talk about all the time about Overway, Vernado, Bolt, all these very good players. But what makes this team so good is their depth. The fact that they can get into foul trouble and they can have a sixth man like Jordan Scott, a freshman, impact freshman, come in and contribute. You can have guys off the bench like Ambrose come in and contribute. You have Winkle who can come in and contribute. All these guys and all these names, and the list just keeps going on and on from, you know, the front of the list to the bottom. That's part of the reason why this Knights team's ranked 12th in the nation and why their record reflects what they have. It's not the individuality of one player. It's a team and team basketball and the culture that this Knights team has built around that. And so Coach Saul being able to sub, you know, guys into big spots early in the game, whether having a lead or down or close game situations, it just goes to show this team and what they're made of.
Yeah, I really agree, Ryan. Very deep bench, and we always see when the subs come in, there's not much differentiation between the talent level or the team on the floor, how much tenacity and athleticism they give out there. Is Overway able to get an offensive rebound on the play before and put one in, and the Bulldogs just missing a three-point opportunity. Now Bolt on the far side with it, trying to get it in to Overway. Wrestler with it on the perimeter. Gets it to Scott. Overway with it down low.
Good pass from Overway to find Vernardo right there.
Love the cut from Bernardo. Overway trying to get the rebound, and too many Bulldogs underneath him.
You know, although the Knights weren't able to finish, I love that play of Overway just seeing over top and finding Bernardo on a backdoor cut.
And a 3-point shot there and DJ Morrow and Ekekeza.
Calvin calls it his first time.
I believe Tripp Reamer's not in the game for the Knights, and the Ryan special music here today. YMCA coming up here in Van Nuys Arena.
Yeah, I love it when YMCA comes on.
Really, the Knights just trying to get a reset now. Lead only at one. Trying to reset and see how they can grow that lead, especially when they were, the hands are going cold right now, not able to hit as many shots as they would like. Trying to get a breather, trying to reset, and try to get this lead back to what it was.
Yeah, definitely, and that defensive pressure has been key for that to this point in the game.
About 15 seconds left in the timeout. Both teams breaking the huddle. Really important that they come out here, and the Knights have an opportunity to score here. Really huge opportunity for them to go back up to a one or two score margin, only up one right now. Something really impressive, Ryan, I know we've talked about it a bit, is the Bulldogs' defense out here. Been really physical, pressured the Knights a lot, and have caused a fair amount of turnovers for the Knights early on.
Yeah, huge credit to the Bulldogs and the way that they've defended to this point, holding the Kelvin Knights to 17 points through almost 15 minutes here in the first half.
Knights with it on their end of the floor. Bolt driving, stripped away. And number 10, Nick Seifert, will save it from going out of bounds. Morrow finding Bulldog in the corner. Morrow with it again. And a travel on DJ Morrow. Knights hopefully looking to slow things down as Bolt looking inbound to Wrestler. Coach Saul calling a play, hopefully getting scoring back going here for the Knights. Bit of a cold streak here in the past 5 or so minutes. Bolt over to Reimersma, gets it into Overway. Overway back out to Bolt to Wrestler. Wrestler thinking from three, driving. Post up, fadeaway, and in for Wrestler.
Really good move there by Wrestler to get in the middle of the paint there. And with confidence, take that fadeaway jumper there and see something fall. Hope we can get him going, that hot hand.
Yeah, really big there. Looked to be more of a trip. And that call go to Chenna Ekekeza. That one would be on the floor, Ryan, as number 10, Nick Seifert, took a fall there.
Yeah, Seifert's played well here, 7 points. Done the majority of the scoring here for the Bulldogs, so we'll see how the Knights go about containing him for the rest of this half, as well as in the second.
Morrow making the step back jumper. Bolt with it, gets it into Overway. Underneath, Overway double team, hits a cutting Wrestler. Wrestler posting up, fade away. And
another one
again.
Yeah, back-to-back fadeaways right there in the middle. We kind of talked about him and his ability to hit there in the middle and his ability just to get hot in a hurry. Good to see Wrestler knocking down a couple of shots.
Yeah, definitely, if that's open, that's going to be Wrestler's bread and butter up to this point. Shot from Morrow, no good. Reimersma gets the rebound, taking it down the floor.
And Reimersma getting high to grab that rebound. We've seen him get up on the rim and perform some impressive dunks, but every time he jumps, it's amazing his athleticism and his ability to get up off the floor.
Ekekeza gets it down underneath and is fouled going up for a shot. So, Uchenna Ekekeza with two shots coming your way. Ekekeza, the senior out of Huntley, Illinois, breaking the 1,000-point mark back earlier this month. Really big milestone for him, and as he continues rank up in the Calvin all-time score leading.
Yeah, sinks that first one from the line. Ekekeza, pretty solid free throw shooter for this Knights team, so a leader out there on the court in all aspects, especially on the defensive end. We talk about the best out there defensively, Uchenna Ekekeza, former MIAA Defensive Player of the Year, just really causing fits for anyone that he's guarding in his athleticism and his ability to run lanes and just know where he needs to be on the floor at all times.
Uchenna knocks down the second. Bulldogs looking to answer. Reitnor hands off to Jordan. Morrow hits Jordan on the cut. And Dane Harvey able to strip it away. The defensive specialist doing his job underneath. Overway fouled from Jordan. Looks like Overway down on the floor. Jordan not happy about that one. His second on the afternoon, so he'll be coming out. Number 14, Reed Schilling, and the junior out of Flushing, Michigan. Bolt inbounds to Wrestler. Wrestler driving over to Bolt. Overway looking for an option. Passes over to Harvey. Mid-range jumper from Wrestler.
Wrestler!
2 points for Wrestler, nothing but nets.
And he's heating up back-to-back-to-back now. Falling for Wrestler. When he gets hot, he's hot.
And a hook shot layup from number 10, Nick Seifert, trying to get that offensive rebound, just rimming out. And Uchenna Ekekeza blocked as he goes to the rim, trying some finesse. Dickerson now with it on the perimeter. Dickerson driving. Uchenna Ekekeza able to intercept the pass. Kicks to the far side to Bolt. Bolt handoff to Overway. Thinking about a mid-range jumper as he drives in. Overway fouled, posting up. And that'll be on number 14.
Paulin 14, Schilling. That's his
Reed Schilling.
The Knights are going to be in the bonus now, Ryan, as they've surpassed that 7 foul mark. It's going to be a one-on-one opportunity for Overway at the line. You talked about it. Overway, for a big fella, pretty darn good at the stripe. 73% from the line coming into play today.
Yeah, definitely something he's been working on throughout the season, as that's really come in handy when it comes to the scoring column. Like we said earlier at the beginning of the games, averaging 20.7 points per game. He continues to go up the scoring column. Overway on his one-on-one opportunity. Bit of toilet bowl action around and around and out on the free throw. Knights lead by 7. Seifert driving. Schilling, turnover, Ekekeza going to the rim and up. A lot of contact on Ekekeza, no foul. Dickerson now with it. Hands off to Schilling. Schilling driving, kicks back out to Reitnor. No good from 3. Bolt now with it. Over to Scott. Scott cross-court pass to Harvey. Into the paint to Overway. Overway, size differential is there. He's trying to get it up off the glass and in.
Overway. Yeah, smothered with defenders right there off of that double team. Overway still so good and able to rise up off the block and kiss it off the glass and find the bottom of the net right there.
Overway guarding Schilling. He pulls from 3. No good off the front of the rim. Multiple Knights on the ground along with the Bulldog. Knights end up with it. Ekekeza with it at the top of the key. Kicks over to Bolt to Harvey. Harvey dribbles to the near side to Scott. Under a minute left to play. Scott driving, lays it off the glass and off the rim. Harvey guarding Dickerson. Ekekeza also on Seifert. And once again, the Bulldogs doing a really great job of ball movement here, Ryan. Find Schilling.
And knocking it down from behind the arc.
Really deep 2-point try. I believe his foot was on that maroon line. And last shot opportunity as Varnado and Riemersma head back to the bench looking to check in. Jordan Scott with it, 8 seconds left. Jordan Scott driving, Pass over to Overway. Overway off the glass and in. 1 second left, and that will do it for the first half. The Knights 29, Bulldogs 20. Knights lead by 9 at the half. Really a lull there. And around the 10-minute mark, Ryan, about halfway through, all scoring seemed to halt for about 4 to 5 minutes and kind of seemed to pick up there towards the end. Really started off hot, especially behind the arc, and then finally got going back there at the end.
Yeah, and if that's something, if you're the Knights, you want to see more of how the Knights just closed the quarter. Get Jalen Overway the basketball just in general. I feel like at times the Knights struggled getting him the basketball in positions where he was able to be successful, and they started to figure out their more towards the end of that first half, but just getting the basketball to Jalen Overway, just letting him be efficient as he is with his touches.
We'll have a presentation here during halftime. And we'll be back with you. It's halftime right now. We've got about 14 minutes left. Just getting the stat sheet in here today. The Knights shooting about, shooting 42% from the field, only 18%, 2 for 11 from behind the arc. So the Knights have got to improve on that. But we got about 14 minutes left of halftime. We'll make sure to be with you about 3 to 4 minutes before the beginning of the second half. But until then, stick with us and make sure to tune in to the halftime presentation. Members of that team are
located. Congratulations, gentlemen, and welcome back. And now, fans, please direct your attention to the court for a special ceremony. This fall, Dale Boss announced his retirement from keeping statistics and scorekeeping after a remarkable 41-year run with the Calvin men's basketball program. A 1985 Calvin University graduate, Boss graduated from Calvin with a degree in business and a knack for numbers. He went on to work as a bookkeeper for several Holland area businesses and has been the chief bookkeeper for Genzing Plumbing for the last 30 years. As a Calvin student, Boss was a varsity letter winner on the final Calvin men's varsity wrestling team. 2 years later, Dale volunteered as a statistician with the Calvin men's basketball program under then head coach Don Drone. The following year, he began working as a statistician for head men's basketball coach Ed Dauma and continued to work for later head coaches Kevin Vanderstreet and Bill Saul. Over his 41 years, Dale never missed an NCAA 3 tournament game that the Calvin men competed in. He was a part of 2 national championship teams and 4 teams that reached the Division III Final Four. He is joined today by his parents Irv and Marianne Boss, his wife Cindy, and his son Michael. Their son Aaron and daughter Emily are not with us today, but offer words of congratulations to their father. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give Dale Boss a hand for 41 years of Calvin, of service at Calvin University.
again, folks. Welcome back to Van Noort Arena, home of the Calvin Knights, for some second half men's basketball action. The Bulldogs taking on the Knights of Calvin. The Knights leading the Bulldogs by 9 through the first half. A little bit of a low-scoring affair so far. The Knights 2-for-11 from behind the arc, 43% shooting from the field, and the Bulldogs 2-for-8 from behind the arc, 33% from the field. Something really interesting to check out from the stat sheet is that the Adrian Bulldogs have not yet shot a free throw up to this point, Ryan, especially with the physicality that we've seen throughout the game, Ryan. I think it's really interesting to look.
Yeah, that's a surprising stat that the Bulldogs have not been to the free throw line to this point tonight. But that's a testament to the Knights' defense, their ability to defend without fouling. We saw the Knights get to the bonus there and get to, every time they were hacked, go to the free throw line there towards the end of the first half. But them staying out of foul trouble for the most part, being able to keep those main contributors that we see night in, night out, this Knights team out there on the floor due to that, and them staying out of foul trouble, which we've seen the Knights struggle with several times this season, is getting into foul trouble and having to switch things up and switch lineups up. But you know, all credit to the Bulldogs there in that first half. They defended really well against one of the best offensive teams in the country. They did a really nice job of keeping the basketball out of Jalen Overway's hands and not letting him get the basketball on the block or in positions where he could be successful. So we'll see if the Bulldogs continue that success at Jalen Overway and overall on the defensive aspect of the game and are able to claw their way back here against the Knights moving on as we get ready to begin half number two, Ryan.
And second half action coming your way. Ekekeza inbounding to Ressler. One last thing before we go here. The Knights only having two offensive rebounds, so Bulldogs able to rebound, especially defensively, really well. The Knights usually having a lot of offensive rebounds. Overway driving in. Foul call drawn by him. Call on number two. Braylon Dickerson, his second on the evening. And Jalen Overway with that basket at the end of the first half ended up surpassing into double digits on his scoring already.
And that's exactly what you want to see if you're the Calvin Knights, getting Jalen over with the basketball early to start the half on the block. And I mentioned it just prior that the Knights really struggled getting Jalen over with the basketball on the block and in positions where he could be successful. So getting him the basketball there on the block, get him started, get him at the free throw line, feeling that touch as he knocked down the first one and the second one right there. No surprise, really good shooter.
And 2-for-2 from the line, Jalen Overway. So good for him, especially the Knights only shooting 50% in the first half. Now Seifert trying to drive against Ekekeza. He is also fouled going up to the rim. Foul called on Ekekeza. I believe that'll be his second on the afternoon.
Yeah, Nick Seifert, 7 points in that first half, looking to add to more here as he heads to the free throw line. The leading scorer for this Bulldogs squad at just under 11 points per game. So definitely someone that the Knights kind of want to hone in on here this half.
Yeah, really big opportunity here for the Bulldogs. Seifert, like you said, usually averaging just under 11 points per game, already at that 8-point mark now, really close to being over his average, and really leading this Bulldogs in the scoring category right now. Ressler taking the ball, passing to the top of the key to Varnado, over to Ekekeza. Backdoor cut. Overway from the three, no good off the rim. Now Dickerson up the floor over to Seifert. Seifert, pull-up jumper, and that's good right around the free throw line.
Really smooth there on the pull-up jumper from Seifert right there without hesitation, knocking that one down from the mid-range.
And Varnado getting hot from the corner three. We've seen him take a few shots in the first half, and really looked for him to get hot. When he gets hot,
yeah, Varnado,
dangerous.
Just adding to the shooting threats for this Calvin Knights team, and recently been one of the main ones, if not the main threat for this Knights team from behind the arc, knocking down triple after triple.
An Overway, a little left-handed hook, no good off the front of the backboard. Like you were saying, Varnado, really big threat here for the Knights, especially if he can get hot. And definitely what we've seen in the past. Varnado stands straight up, and Seifert goes up. Offensive rebound for number 24, Chrisman. Ressler moving the ball up the floor now. Vernado from three. Bang!
Another one. Owen Vernado, when he gets hot, he gets going. And Owen Vernado knocking down two in a row from behind the arc. Back-to-back triples for Owen Vernado as he's heating up, and so are the Knights.
And Ryan, really what you want to see out of the Knights coming out at halftime, not even 2 minutes into it, and the Knights already knocking down a total of 8 points. Vernado, six of them himself, and overweight, another two on free throw tries. Quick 30-second timeout from the Adrian Bulldogs. Tim Razor on the timeout call. Really good timeout call from the Bulldogs, trying to limit the momentum from the Knights as they are now up 14.
Definitely.
Both teams coming out of the huddle now, getting ready. Some more action. Seifert inbounding to Rex Steiner. Bulldogs moving the ball well up to this point. Seifert now trying to drive against Vernado. Vernado using his chest, trying to drive. Foul called on Vernado. I believe that'll be his second on the afternoon.
Vernado, that's his second. Team second.
You know, Vernado's got to be careful now not to pick up number three too early. You know, with two fouls here at this point in the second half, not too concerned. But definitely the Knights needed Vernado and his contributions on the floor. The Knights are a better basketball team with Owen Vernado on the floor. So anything he can do to stay on the floor.
And a block there for Marcus Bolt. Wrestler up the near side. Pass into a driving Bolt. Wrestler from behind the arc, no good.
And that one no good for Wrestler, but we saw him hit back-to-back shots in the first half. So if we can get him going and get him hot again, that's going to be huge for this Kelvin Knights team. Wrestler, it never seems to be just one when it finds the bottom of the net. Seems to be that there's going to be many to follow shortly after.
Yeah, for sure. On that note, Wrestler coming off with Jordan Scott, the really big impact freshman for the Knights, coming into this one as the Bulldogs take a step on the baseline. It'll be Knights ball.
Yeah, I like to compare Wrestler to Microwave. As soon as you press go, it's just hot and stays hot. So we'll see if Wrestler, the Microwave, can get going here in this second half as he takes a seat.
Really love the analogy there, Ryan, is Vernado getting fouled, trying to drive into the hoop.
Foul on number two, Dickerson, that's his third. Team second.
Bolt looking inbound. Scott guarded closely by Rex Steiner. Scott driving up, a little fancy with it, fouled at the rim. Two shots on the way for Jordan Scott. DJ Morrow checking in for the Bulldogs. Ryan, really loved the decision to drive there and go up for Jordan Scott. Really getting physical along, kind of giving me some Chenna Ekekeza flashbacks.
Yeah, Jordan Scott, such a talented athlete. His ability just to hang in the air and absorb contact, and anytime he can get going and attack downhill.
Number one,
yeah, very dangerous game when he can get it going downhill. As Trip Riemersma checks in for Owen Vernado, Jordan Scott puts down his second as well. Knights lead by 16 now as Rex Steiner, driving against Scott. Hand off to Seifert. Seifert driving, floater off the rim and good.
Nick Seifert.
Seifert making his presence known down there, Ryan. Scott finding Bolt in the corner from three. Bang! And the Knights are hot from behind the arc.
Yeah, Marcus Bolt knocking it down from the corner right there.
And Ekekeza guarding Morrow. Overway not letting Jordan post up and travel. Called on Josh Jordan, the senior from Muskegon, Michigan. Jalen Overway playing some great defense underneath, not letting Jordan drive into him at all, Ryan. Bolt with it, pass over on the near side to Scott. Scott from behind the arc. No good.
Bolt keeping the play alive right there. I like that hustle out of him.
Yeah, great job there. Offensive rebound, finding Jalen all the way underneath, and the easy 2 points for the big man down south.
And what seems like it's been in a blink of an eye, the lead now has grown for the Knights, now at 19.
Yeah, really
the
big lead.
The scoring coming alive for these Knights.
Yeah, big scoring affair here, especially early on in this second half. Akakeza driving up, and no good on the initial shot. But a foul call as Shanna Akakeza goes down. And Ryan, you know we always talk about it on the broadcast, but Akakeza so strong when he goes up to the rim.
Yeah, definitely one of the more physical guys on this Kelvin Wright Knights roster. And in this conference, you know, there's not many as physical as Uchenna Akakeza.
Akakeza looking for his first few substitutions for both of the squads. Looking to come in. Akakeza knocks down the first. That'll be his third point on the afternoon. So a little bit of a quieter afternoon for Akakeza. Able to finally draw a foul underneath. Brady Ewing in for Jalen Overway. And Akakeza not able to sink the second. Brady Ewing gets the offensive rebound after the free throw. The Knights get it back to Jordan Scott. Screen and pick and roll there from Bolt. Bolt with it on the near side, spinning baseline. Seven to shoot, fadeaway jumper. No good off the back of the rim. Riemersma picking up Reitnor, initially full court. Bulldogs with the ball on the near side. Moving it quickly, shot from Crispin behind the arc, no good.
Yeah, we'll see if the Bulldogs can get that shooting touch going here. Not a lot of offense for them here to start the second half.
Yeah, Ryan, only 5 points in the second half so far. He's not able to get the shooting going so far. Jordan Scott, floater, off the rim and out. Bulldogs looking for an opportunity. Morrow kicks it in to Schilling. Coming around is Crispin. Almost out. And Morrow will try to reset for the Bulldogs. And that'll be a foul call on Jordan Scott.
Foul on Jordan Scott, number 12. That's his first, team number
Bolt
three.
And Scott coming off the floor along with Akakeza, Winkle, Ambrose, and Ressler into the game. So could be looking for some more of a sharp shooting action like we saw in the first half. More of the sharp shooting lineups here from the Knights. Crispin driving against Winkle. Kicks out to Schilling from three. No good. Ambrose on the rebound. Ambrose finds Winkle on the near side. Winkle handoff to Ressler. Ressler guarded closely by Crispin. Knights looking for an opportunity. 10 to shoot. Dreamers went driving baseline. Ewing has an opportunity, driving 3 seconds. Throws up a shot and in. Nice jumper right there from Brady Ewing.
Yeah, nice shot from Ewing right there. Strong and composed in the middle of the paint right there, knocking it down.
Yeah, Ryan Ewing out there, you could tell a lot more confidence and really continued to gain confidence over the course of the season. Another big impact freshman for the Knights. Foul call there. Owen Varnado checking back into the game for the Knights. Matt Ambrose will come back off.
Yeah, Ewing a big, strong freshman at 6'7", 210 pounds out there on the court. Showcasing that right there, banging a little bit in the paint and knocking it down.
It looks like we got a full timeout called once again by Coach Tim Pacer. And the Bulldogs trying to really halt this momentum shift. By the Knights now scoring 47, the lead at 22 right now. It's a huge differential between halftime and now, and it's only been about 7 minutes. And the Bulldogs only been able to put in five so far through the second half, so they gotta find out a way to figure out, get some shots to drop, try to find a way to get back in this game.
Definitely.
You know, Ryan, something that might work for the Bulldogs is if they would come out in a full court press. We've seen it work against the Knights in a few instances. And we saw it earlier today during the fourth quarter of the women's game. Able to halt the Knights a little bit earlier in that game. Let's see if they'll come out. And excuse me, Ambrose still in for the Knights. Reimer's mom was the substitution for Varnado, so Varnado out on the floor right now.
Yeah, Varnado's hot shooting hand. We saw him knock down a couple of triples back-to-back here earlier in the half, so we'll see if they can utilize his offensive contributions for the remainder of this second half.
Morrow jump shot blocked by Ressler. Ressler on the near side in transition, kicking over to Ambrose. Ambrose from three, bang!
And there's that sharp shooting hand of Matt Ambrose we talked about. We talked about Coach Saul's frustration with him a little bit for passing up a shot. Not for shooting, never for shooting. Always want Matt Ambrose to shoot the basketball when it's in his hand, just like that, and he's able to knock it down. One of the best sharp shooters on this team.
Yeah, really great shot there from Ambrose, and I'm sure Coach will be a little bit happier after that one instead of driving in, able to get it there. Fadeaway shot there from number 10, McSeifert. Just Winkle carrying it up. Ressler trying to get it in to Varnado. Knights retain possession. Right now, Ambrose kicks
Varnado
over to
for
Varnado.
Three again. No good.
Too far for Varnado's 3-point try. Knights still lead by 25. Seifert driving in, poked away by the Knights. Knights on the floor. Ambrose ends up with it. Ambrose to Ressler, Knights in transition.
Ambrose again.
Ambrose from three.
Bang! Matt Ambrose in transition again. Back to back for Matt Ambrose, knocking it down from behind the line. Man, is he good from behind the arc.
And Coach Saul hyped about that one. Ambrose letting it fly, two back to back. And the Knights lead grows to 28. Morrow in the paint, good, and just like we talked about, Ryan, Bulldogs starting to pick up a bit, full court press, as we have about 11 and a half minutes to play. Ewing with it now over to Varnado. Varnado driving baseline, kicks over to Winkle. Winkle, corner three, no good, off the front of the rim. And now Bulldogs driving baseline, kick out and back in, back and forth, looking for a three-point opportunity. Now Michael Reitnoir takes it and hits the three for the Bulldogs. Full court press for the Bulldogs here, Ryan. Let's see if the Knights figure out a way to break it. Not too much of a, just a bit of pressure, it seems like. Ewing with it now on the far side. Ewing driving. Hands off to Ressler. Ressler to Ambrose. Eight to shoot on the shot clock. Over to Varnado. Varnado driving baseline over to Ambrose. Ambrose has got to shoot it. Not able to get a shot off. Blocked by Chrisman. Bolt, Ekekeza, and Overway in the game for the Knights. Ambrose and Varnado stick in the game. DJ Morrow inbounds to Recksteiner. Morrow handoff to Recksteiner once again. Recksteiner driving. And the Bulldogs moving around the perimeter well. Dickerson. Back out to number 32, Jordan, driving on Overway. And stepped out on the baseline. Jordan not happy about that one. Just under halfway through the second half. Knights still lead by about 23. Ekekeza trying to drive there, kicks over to Ambrose. Overway. A lot of physical contact down there, all the way up near the arc, trying to get the ball and have an opportunity underneath. Ekekeza gets it back out on the outside, looking for options, 10 to shoot. Ekekeza to Ambrose in the corner. Ambrose driving and a layup off the glass. Jalen Oubre initially able to get a rebound. Bulldogs in transition. DJ Morrow from three and good. And a timeout from Coach Tim Pacer and the Bulldogs. Full timeout trying to get things going. Would not be surprised, Ryan, if the Bulldogs here drop into more of a formalized press, trying to get some traps in as we see Jordan Scott come to game for tonight.
Yeah, good timeout call there by Coach Kaiser to get this Bulldogs team in a system here to put some more points up on the board.
Yeah, really big Darius. Bulldogs starting to get hot there. Is a three-point try from DJ Morrow. Good, the freshman out of Lake O'Brien, Michigan. So both teams out here having some big impact. Freshman, it's about halfway through the timeout. Coach Saul trying to get some things going on the offensive side again. Definitely more of a scoring affair than what we saw in the first half. Knights 53, Adrian Bulldogs 33, so the Knights lead by 20. Be interesting to see any defensive or offensive changes from both of these squads out here. Both teams breaking the huddle right now. It looks like Jordan Scott checked in for Matt Ambrose. Just like we talked about, Ryan, Bulldogs dropping into a little bit more of a formalized press. Let's see if they'll try to trap it all. Bull inbounds to Jordan Scott. Morrow picks him up at full court. Oubre on the screen. Knights trying to slow things down. Oubre with it now. We're on the perimeter. Kicks over to Barnato. Barnato driving baseline. 6 seconds. Scott with a floater and in.
What a nice find there from Barnato, finding Scott cutting into the middle for that floater right there.
Rex Steiner finding some Bulldogs. No good on the triple try there from Dickerson. Ekekeza driving. Finds Jordan Scott. Scott going up hard and off the glass. Looked like he got hit in the face there. He is down on the floor right now. And Ekekeza looked to have fouled an attempt to try to stop play to see if Jordan Scott's okay.
Team number five.
Wrestler and Riemersma in the game. Jordan Scott and Varnado taking a seat on the bench. Morrow possessing the ball for the Bulldogs. Over to Jordan. Dickerson finding Reitenoir on the far side. Dickerson with once again driving block from Riemersma. Wrestler gets the rebound. Foul from Rex Steiner.
Foul at 20, Rex Steiner, that's his third.
Be his third on the evening, so a bit of foul trouble for him as we also see Reitenoir coming off the court. Look to be Seifert checking back in here for the Bulldogs. He's up to 12 points on the evening. Oubre underneath finding Riemersma and a two-handed flush down the baseline. What a find from Jalen Oubre, Ryan.
Yeah, fantastic find from Oubre. We talked about Riemersma and his athleticism and his ability just to get up off the floor and showcasing that right there in some fashion.
Jordan Scott coming back into this game. And Jalen Oubre gets that one after touching the glass. So goaltending on Jalen Oubre. Wrestler coming out. Jordan Scott back in. So looks to be he's okay. Scott picked up at half court by Chrisman. Screen from Jalen Oubre. pick and roll for Jalen Overway off the backboard and in. Overway, 16 points on the evening. Seifert finding Rex Steiner and George Scott fouling.
Jordan Scott for the second personal foul, team number
six. A turnover there on the little bit of a lob pass opportunity. Inbound to Seifert. Seifert, fake from three. Pick and roll for the Bulldogs. No good from Jordan. Possession goes back to the Bulldogs. Looks like it was chipped out by the Knights. Just under seven left to play in this one. Seifert inbounds to Dickerson. Bulldogs 15 to shoot. Driving baseline now is Seifert. Ekpeza fouling Seifert underneath the hoop on the opportunity.
Fourth foul on Ekpeza. Two free throws for Seifert.
Dane Harvey checking in after the first free throw here. Big defensive specialist on this Knights roster. Dane,
11, Dane Harvey
in for Luciana Ekpeza. Seifert, his second is good. Bolt inbounding quickly to Scott. Scott on the near side. Overway thinking about it from three. Backdoor cut from Scott. Overway from behind the arc. No good, a little short. Chrisman handoff. Now Chrisman from three. No good. Offensive rebound. And that will be out of bounds on the Bulldogs. Brady Ewing in the game for the Knights for Jalen Overway. Ryan, the Knights continuing to separate themselves from the Bulldogs, sitting pretty consistently at that 25-point lead.
Yeah, the offense has really clicked here in the second half for this Knights squad. So for the Bulldogs, can't really say the same. Only 16 points here to this point in the second half, and that's not going to get it done against a team as talented as this Kelvin Knights squad.
Brady Ewing from three behind the arc. Bang! And Brady Ewing is hot. A freshman making an impact here tonight. Lead grows to 28. Trying to get the steal on Josh Jordan. That'll be a foul call on Ewing.
Ewing commits the foul, that's his first.
Ewing up to 5 points on the evening. That'll be his first foul. Josh Jordan heads to the line, the senior. Not able to knock down the first is Jordan. Just under six left to play here. Jordan, 0 for 2 on the free throws. Bolt with the rebound, kicks out to Scott. Winkle heading in front of us right now, looking to check in. Long with number 30, Logan Van Essen. Bolt driving now, hands off to Riemersma. Jordan Scott with it, 10 seconds to shoot. Backdoor cut for Dane Harvey. Turnover for the Knights. Loose ball. Bulldogs end up with it. Three try from Crispin, no good. Bolt going up for the rebound. Number two, Braylon Dickerson, able to get the offensive rebound. And put one in off the glass. Knights slowing things down as Jordan Scott possesses up the floor. Harvey with it now. Kicks over to Scott. Bolt over to Riemersma. Riemersma behind the arc. No good. Just a bit long. As Rex Steiner pulls down the rebound. Seifert. Trying to drive off, I believe, the foot of Harvey.
Marcus Bolt
coming
out.
Along with Riemersma, Winkle, and Van Essen head into the game.
And 30, Logan Vanessen.
Rex Steiner inbounding, ball over to Chrisman. Dickerson thinking about it from three, trying to drive against Winkle. Step back, jumper, no good. Offensive rebound for the Bulldogs. Chrisman driving, taken away from by Harvey. Harvey up, blocked, and a shot. Shot blocked and a foul there. Contact before the shot. Dane Harvey at the line now, shooting two.
A nice steal there for Dane Harvey.
Two free throws.
Yeah, Harvey, what a great defender and really great steal there. Able to get two free throws for himself here.
Yeah, ranks third on the team in steals for a guy that doesn't rack up a lot of minutes. Pretty impressive.
Yeah, very impressive indeed. Right now, checking in is number 21, Michael Morris, sophomore out of Grand Rapids. And Harvey knocks down both shots, 2 for 2 on the evening. Seifert taking it up the floor once again. Jordan hands off to Dickerson. Dickerson looking for a shot, driving. Pass to Jordan, pass to the corner to MC. And no good from three. Dickerson driving in, no good. Ball still on the rim. Finally put in there by Josh Jordan.
Passing by 32, Josh Jordan.
Harvey now with it, taking it up the floor. On Williams, kicks over to Morris. Van Essen with it. Van Essen finds Winkle down low, posting up and in off the glass, not able to put it in, but two free throws for him.
Good cut there by Winkle into open space right there, and a nice find from the wing to get him the basketball in a position where he could be successful. And now he's gonna go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Yeah, really great find there. Let's see if Winkle can knock down these two. The lead still around 26 here for the Knights.
Yeah, and Trevin Winkle, a very good free throw shooter, 83.3%. Gotta be precise right there on the dot, Ryan. But a very good free throw shooter for this Knights team.
Yeah, gotta include the decimal places there on the percentage. Makes it sound
they're important.
A little bit more professional here at Calvin University. And Winkle knocking down his first. And able to hit his second there as his might be up to 0.4 now on the old free throw percentage. And the Knights lead grows to 28.
Attention to detail and the little things, which is what makes this Calvin Knights basketball team so good, is that they do the little things. They box out, they rebound, they go for loose balls, they hustle.
Yeah,
so
really
separates those good teams from the great teams. And so another reason, along with the depth, why this Calvin Knights team is ranked 12th in the nation.
Logan now with it, steal from Harvey. Harvey headed down the court, looking for options, kicks back to number 34, Cook. Now Morris looking to drive, kicks out to Harvey. Harvey driving baseline and in. Great drive on the baseline for Harvey. Williams now with it, handoff to Logan. And it looks to be another steal for Harvey. Gives it forward to Mitchell Cook, up and lays it off the backboard and in. Timeout from Coach Saul. Get some substitutions in. Harvey and Ewing coming out. Harvey with multiple steals in the past few minutes. 32-point lead for the Knights.
Adrian calls timeout just for subs.
And man, Ryan, has this offense come alive in the second half for the Calvin Knights.
Very much so. Knights really expanding their lead and continuing to do so. A little bit of sloppy play there from the Bulldogs. Shock driving. Now Schilling to the rim and in. Dick Dirksen inbounds to Van Essen. Logan heads it up at the top of the key. Cook heads it up at the top of the key. Dirksen Back over to Morris. Morris driving, fouled, and he'll have two free throws to shoot at the line. Just under 2 minutes left to play.
Ball on 12
in the game.
His first. Michael
Morris. Now uncalled on number 12, Jake Trampush. Michael Morris able to sink his first. Morris able to sink his second, 2 for 2 from the line in that trip.
Yeah, extending the lead now to 32. Knights well in control here at home.
Now Goldpool guarding along with Cook. A little physical contact on the layup there. No call is Mitchell Morris. Yeah, heads in there. Michael Morris, heads in there for a layup. No good. Goldpool takes it out, gives it to Cook. Just nearing the 1 minute mark left to play. Van Essen with it in the corner, guarded closely, driving baseline, pull-up jumper, no good. Williams driving for the Bulldogs. Driving baseline, finds number 12, Trampush in the corner, and off the rim and in.
Shooter's touch right there off the rim, falling in for the triple try to be good. 74-47 now with the final minute of play.
Really great opportunity there from the corner. No good on the opportunity there from Morris. That'll be a foul on Dirksen. Number 5, Lucas Schock, driving to the rim.
Ball on 24, Gabe Dirksen is first.
Gabe Dirksen on the foul. Lucas Schock, the junior, out of St. Clair Shores, Michigan, headed to the line to shoot two. First one, just like his three-point try, off the rim and in. Shock. His second is good. Cook for the Knights. Passes to Goldpool. Morris now over to Dirksen. Dirksen from behind the arc. Bang! And Dirksen from a few feet behind the arc. Nothing but net. Guarding the shot from Seth Logan. That'll be 3 from the line here for Logan. Sophomore out of Fenton, Michigan.
His first. Free throws for number 4, Logan.
Logan's first is good. Shot clock is off. 12.9 seconds left to play. Would assume that the Knights will just dribble this one out. Logan's second. No good. Trampush looking for a rebound there, although free to shoot. Logan, his third is good. Knights inbound to Cook. It looks like he'll dribble this one out.
Well, Ryan, that's going to do it from Vonore Arena. It looks like the Knights are going to take this one 77-51. Overall, a really good performance and good showing for the Calvin Knights, especially offensively in that second half, bouncing back from kind of a slow start on the offensive end of the half, number one.
Really good second half showing there. A lot of points, a lot of offense there. Really love to see percentages there, but a lot of shots made, especially towards the beginning. They're able to jump out to a quick lead after what seemed like a really slow and defensive-minded first half turned into a really offensive-minded second half. So kind of two opposites attracting there, and just some great ball played by the reserves there at the end as well. You know, we talked to Coach Saul before. able to get those reserves in is always such a good job, because they do such a great job for the program, get them some minutes, and a lot of them able to get put up some points on the board and do a great job there.
Yeah, definitely, and a really good showing on the defensive end here tonight as well, holding the Bulldogs to 51 points.
And Coach Saul coming over for an interview.
Winkle, 2. Barnado, 8. Overweight, 14. Wrestler, 6. Harvey with 4.
Hey, Coach Saul, congratulations on the win. Anytime you can get a win in conference, especially on the home floor, has to be a good feeling for you and your squad, right?
Yeah, I mean, for sure. I thought, you know, Adrian came out in the first half, and you know, we missed some shots we normally make, and we got some wide open looks, but I thought our defense was pretty solid. And then I think in the second half, we just did a great job of locking down. You know, some big transition baskets. You know, good to see Owen make a few shots. And then, you know, we were able to capitalize in some situations. I mean, I was really happy. You know, I think we turned it over maybe once or twice in the second half, so that was really good as well.
Yeah,
so, you know, overall, yeah, good performance, what you need to be able to do this time of the year in the league.
Yeah, definitely clicking a little bit more offensively in the second half. What were kind of some of the adjustments you guys made from the first half to the second half to kind of focus on your guys getting in positions you guys
can
be successful?
Well, I mean, I think number one, first, and it's always the case, right? I mean, it's like in the first half, we like to push the ball, but our guys are running and we're sprinting, right? I mean, it's a big difference. And, you know, the second half, we started to get up the floor, so we got some pushes, which gives us some space. And we just played at a better pace, and that makes a world of difference.
Yeah, and Harvey, every time he's on there, seems to be like a little spark plug for you guys in his defensive effort. What does he just bring to you guys and your squad with his energy and his ability to
defend?
Well,
he just brings so much energy defensively, and, you know, he's a spark plug every day in practice, too. He's a consummate leader, and he's that guy that just literally wants to do everything he can do to help us win. And so it was just great, again, to see him do some good things again today.
Yeah, well, thank you, Coach, and congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
And you heard it there, Ryan. Big game out of the entire staff. There's a big overall game. Nick Seifert for the Bulldogs with 13, along with DJ Morrow, also 10 in the double digits. Jalen Overway, per usual, at 16. And the rest of the Knights, really participating across the board together. Something really interesting, Ryan, is we're looking, both teams, 36 rebounds on the night, so very equal rebounding game. Like we talked about, the Bulldogs come out with a very powerful defensive energy. Knights making an adjustment there in the second half.
Yeah, and you know, that adjustment and the offensive power didn't come from just one person. You know, obviously the leading scorer, Jalen Overway, was 16, but there, as I look down the stat sheet, it's 8, 7, 6, 6, 7, 2, 5, 6. It just keeps going on and on. You know, it felt like everyone contributed this tonight in terms of scoring and getting their fingers in the ball and, you know, finding the bottom of the net. You know, it would be at moments that Wrestler would get hot or Bolt would get hot or even Harvey getting some steals and setting up some people.
Yeah, really great opportunity there. I loved how Coach talked about, like, anything that he can do to get in the game, that's what he's going to do, and he's going to do it to the best of his ability, bring the energy. Really great to see out of there, and something really important to see. Look at the stat sheet, is Knight shooting 43% from three in the second half. So a big three-point shooting affair for them, along with 92% free throws. So that'll do it here in the broadcast. This is Ryan, and Ryan, we hope you have a great night. Stay safe. God bless, and we'll see you guys next time. Ryan and Ryan signing off.